Good morning, dear children. Stay home, be safe. Myself, Shweta Ravi Kumar. I will be taking mathematics for you, that is for the 6th grade. So today, let us start the first chapter of mathematics. Before going to the name of the chapter, in the previous classes we studied about the numbers. Okay? So in day-to-day life, we use so many example for use of numbers. That is, at what time you will get up in the morning? You will tell that 6 o'clock. So what is that 6? 6 is a number. Next, what is the marks in your mathematics test? That is 80, 82, 90. So what is this 80, 82, 90? It is also number. Next, if you want to draw the money from the bank, that is, you will draw the money 2000, 3000 or 500. So these all are the numbers. So wherever you go in your day-to-day life, you want the numbers. So from the ancient, whatever the people are there, they used to represent the number in the form of the stone or the line and all. But afterwards, mathematician discovered the numbers to use this counting, whatever you will do, 1, 2, 3, 4 and all. So here today, we will study about based on the numbers, that is the first chapter in 6th standard, that is knowing our numbers. So in this, let us proceed the first concept in this chapter, that is the comparing numbers. What is the meaning of comparing? For example, in mathematics test, if you will get 20 marks and you go to your friend and ask how many marks you got. That is, she will tell, I got 22. So you will compare the marks between you and your friend. So that is the comparing of number, which is you got more marks, she got less marks. So you will compare who got more marks and less marks. So that is what we call as the comparing numbers. So I have taken you one example. Based on that, two examples I have taken. And we studied how to compare the numbers. So, I have given example 1, 382, 4972, 80, 59,785. How to compare the numbers? Yesterday in the previous classes, the place values. That is, place value means 1, 10, 100, 1000 and all. So, which is having the less place value? Based on that, you can decide which is the greatest number and the smallest number. So, that one I will write here. So first you will write which is the greatest number. So which is the greatest? Next you will write which is the smallest number for the given number I have given in the example 1. So can you tell me which is the greatest number? Here I told which is having the greatest place value. You can tell that it is the greatest number. So here it is 382 is there. So 1 stands 100. So here 1 stands 100,000 is there. So 1 stands here, it is 1 stands 100,000, 10,000. So you can say that this is a greatest number. So here, which is the greatest number here? 59,785. This is a greatest number. Then which is the smallest number here? So this is having the lowest place value, that is the 1s and 10s. So we can say that it is a smallest number. So here we have compared here between the greatest and the smallest number. Let us take another example based on this. So see here and tell me which is the greatest and the smallest number. So which is the greatest number here? So here which is having the greatest place value? So which is having the greatest place value? That is 89,423. So 89,423 is the greatest number. Which is the lowest number here? That is the smallest. 1473 is having the thousands place. Here also thousands place is there. But here in the thousands place, 5 is there, here 1 is there. Okay? So that we cannot tell as the smallest. Before that, which is the lowest here? 310. So your smallest number will be 310. So, I have understood this concept. So, compare digits. So 2, 4, 7, 8. So we can write this 2478 is the smallest digit. How many digit have we able to find out? Here 4 digit number can be formed using greatest and the smallest number. Let us take another example based on that. Okay. So here we make by using the 4 digit that given 4750. So greatest number. Next smallest. So which is the greatest digit here? 7 is the greatest digit. Next which is the greatest? 7, 5. Next is the 4. Last comes the 0. So here 7, 5, 4, 0 is the greatest number. So how we can read this? 7,540. So here next you have to make the smallest digit. You may think that 0 should be added first term. So if you add 0 first term, it has no meaning. After the number only if you add 0, it has the meaning, the formation of the number. So which is the lowest number before 0? Before 0 it is 4. So your 4 you should write first, next 0, next 5, next 7. So here the smallest digit is which one? 4057. I think you have understood this. So you can take more example based on this, and how many digits are given? You have to form the digit without repetition that is given. Without repetition. If it is given with repetition, then you have to take for 2 means 2, you have to take 2 times. If you have given only 2 numbers means you have to take 2, 3 times. Like okay? So I think you have understood this concept. Next we shall move to the another concept, the writing of numbers in ascending and descending order. What do you mean by ascending? Ascending means yesterday in previous class, from smaller number to bigger number you will write. Descending means from bigger number to smaller. So we will write, I have told in comparing numbers how to compare the largest number and the smallest number. Based on that, which is the smaller, from smaller to bigger you have to write in ascending order. Descending means from bigger to smaller. Okay. So next, first we will write here in ascending order. Okay. So in ascending order, how to write? 847, 9754, 8320, 571. So which is the smallest number here? Smallest number is 571. So 571, comma. Next, which is the smallest number? 847. Next comes 8320. Next comes 9754. So this is in ascending order. Ascending order means from smaller number to the greatest number. Next we should write in descending order. So descending order means what? From bigger number to smaller number. So you can write in this in reverse way. That is 9754, 8320, 847, 571. So this is the way we can write the numbers in ascending and descending order. Let us take another example here. That is, first we can write in ascending order. So which is the smallest number here? Okay, so smallest number, I told that based on the place values you can decide which is having the greatest number. Based on that you can write the in ascending order. So which is the in ascending order, first number will come 1971. Next which one will come? 45321. Okay. Next one, which is the next one? 88,750. Next is 92,547. Okay. Next we will write it in descending order. I think so the same question you got now. For confusing they have given the question as it is. You can write it in the ascending order. So let us write in the descending order. In the reverse way we can write. That is 92,547. Next 88. number and the smallest number. Okay, next we have studied how to write the numbers in ascending and descending order. Ascending means what? The numbers we will write from smaller to bigger. Descending orders means what? From bigger to smaller. I think you have understood the three concepts here based on the knowing our numbers chapter. So let us proceed in the next class, the next concept which comes in the knowing our number chapter. Thank you children. Let us continue the class. In the previous class, we studied how to compare the numbers, shifting of the digits, and writing the numbers in ascending and descending order. And you have seen in the previous class, you took only the small numbers. Today, let us introduce about the large numbers. So, you might have seen that while forming the numbers, what do you want? You want digits. So what are the digits here? You might have seen the digit means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the digits which we need for forming the large numbers, any numbers it may be. Okay, so here for example, if you consider 1, 9 afterwards 10, 10 means you will write first 0 here. Okay, next here 1 is a digit and 1 is number also. If we consider 5, 5 is a digit and it is a number, means it is a single digit number. So using this one, we will form the large digit numbers. Okay, for example, if I take here digit, here 1, 1 digit number. So which is the smallest 1 digit number? It is nothing but 0. 0 is 1 digit. That is the smallest 1 digit number. Which is the greatest 1 digit number? Obviously it is 9. Yes? Next. Let us make the 2 digit number. So 2 digit number means, for example, if it is 9 the greatest digit number, after 9 which number will come? 10, 11, 12, 13, like that it will continue. So for that say, 9 is the greatest digit, single digit number means 10 if you consider, it becomes what? 2 digit number. So for that say, here smallest 2 digit number is 10. Then which is the greatest 2 digit number? So we can write it as 99. So it is a greatest 2 digit number. So an easy method I will tell how to calculate the smallest and the greatest digit number. That is, for example, I told that 9 afterwards the 10 will come. That will become smallest digit number. So you can add 1 for that. So a 9 plus 1 is what? 10. Okay. So that becomes the smallest digit number, 2 digit number. Next, greatest 2 digit number is 99. Add 1 for this, it will become 100. So 100 means how many digits over? 1, 2, 3. Means here 3 digit number, smallest 3 digit number will become 100. So here 3 digit means I have written 3 numbers here. Okay. Next, what is the greatest 3 digit number? As here 3 is there, you can write 999. Means 3 digit number, 9 you can write 3 times. It is easy now. How to find out? So here plus 1 if you do, what it becomes? 1000. Means 1000 next it will become 4, the smallest digit number. So here it will become 1000. Next, what is the greatest 4 digit number? As I told, 4 digits is there. Means you can write 9, 4 times 9, 9, 9, 9, and add for that 1. So how much it will become? 10,000. Yes, no children? So 10,000 will become what? Next, 5 digit, smallest 5 digit number. You can count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? Like that, greatest digit number is what? So as it is 5 digit number, so you can write 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, plus digit number will become 1 lakh. So here 0, 10, 100, 1000, 10000, 1 lakh. So we have reached to the 6th digit, smallest digit number is 1 lakh. Next, we write 9 how many times? After this 6 times we write 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. How many times was 6? Plus 1. So what it becomes? It will become 10 lakh. Okay, next, what is the 7 digit number? Smallest 7 digit number? 10 lakh. Okay, next, how many times I have tried to form a greatest digit number? 9 should be written 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Plus 1. What it will become after lakh, 10 lakh? Crore. That is 1 crore. So next, which digit will can make 8? Smallest 8 digit number, that is it will become crore. 1 crore. So next you can add here, that is 9, how many times you should write? 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 plus 1. What it will become? 10 crore. Okay, so like this you can make the smallest and the greatest, smallest and greatest digit number, that is the large number you can make. So you can see here, this is the 6th digit number, that is lakh. Then afterwards the 8 digit number, that is the crore. You have studied in 5th standard, that is 7th and 8th digit number, that is the crore and the 10 crore. Like this you can make the large numbers by using the digits. I think you have understood this one. Okay, next we'll move on for the next, that is the relation between these numbers. So we have taken two examples here. What is the relation between lakh and thousand? 1 lakh is equal to dash thousand. So 1 lakh is equal to how many thousand? So you know that 1 lakh is right like this. Okay, 1 lakh is equal to, we will equate that. Okay, you know that 1000 means what will you write? 1000. Yes, so 1000 means here 3 zeros are there. Here lakh we will take, 3 zeros means 1000. So how many zeros are remaining here? 2 zeros. So you multiply with 100. Means 100 into 1000 will give 1 lakh. So 1 lakh is equal to 100,000. I think you have understood this. Yes? Let us take another example. 1 lakh is equal to how much? How many? 100. So 1 lakh means how will you write? Write like this. 100 means how will you write? 100. Into how many numbers you have to add for this one? 100 means 2 zeros. Yes? So how many zeros are remaining here? 1, 2, 3 zeros. So you multiply by 1000. So 1 lakh is equal to 1,100. I think how understood how to relate between these numbers, because this will come in your exercise. For that sake, I gave example how to relate between the numbers. It may be lakh to million, crore to million, or million to crore, like that. At that time, what you have to do, you understood the step now. So you have to equate that, how many millions, crores, and all you have to learn. Okay, so today you have learned how to the large numbers using the digits. Next, we learn the relation between these numbers. Children, let us continue the class today. In the previous class, we studied about the forming of the large numbers, okay, and relationship between the two numbers, how to form that one. So today, let us continue the class with exercise 1.1, which we learn how to write the numbers. It means the aid of learning the numbers in both the Indian system and international system. You have studied in 5th standard how to write in Indian system and international system, both in words as well as the numerals. So let us record that and we will solve this exercise sums. Okay, so here exercise 1.1, insert commas suitably and write the names according to Indian system. So in Indian system, what are the place values you will consider? The place values is, first is ones, tens, hundreds. 100, 1000, 10,000. Okay, then lakh, 10 lakh, then crore. Okay, these are the place values studied in the 5th standard. How to write for the Indian system? Okay, we have to write this first sum based on the Indian system. First, you have to put the commas. Okay, so how to put the commas here? What is the use of commas? Commas means you have to separate the periods. That is, first is the 100 periods, then thousands, then lakh, then crores. Okay. Lakh and 10 lakh, 1 crore and crore is another. Next, we should write it in the form of words in Indian system. So, how to write? We will read this first one. How to read 8 crore 75 lakh 95,762? That we have to write in words one. So, here 8 crore. 92,762. Okay, so like this you have to write the words. Let us see another sum, second sum. So first what we have to do? First we have to separate it by using the commas. That is, 1 stands 100, next 1000, 10,000, lakh and 10. So how to read this one? 85,46,283. So here 85,46,283. Okay, so like this you have to write it in Indian system. Okay, let's take another example, that is third sum. Okay, first we will put the commas. Okay, 100 period, 1000 period, lakh period and crore. So here how to write? So 9 crore 99 lakh 46. As the other place, sorry, 1000's place is not given, they have written the 0. That place no need to write, directly you can write the one. So here 9 crore 9 crore 99 lakh 46. Okay, because here the 100's place, 1000's place is not given, so you can write 9 crore 99 lakh 46. Let us take another example. So here put the commas first. So when you read this, 9 crore 84 lakh 32,701. So here 1. Okay, like this you have to write in the words. So here the first four sums are solved in the exercise 1.1. It leaves with, that is, you have to put the commas and write in the names according to Indian system. Okay, so in next class we will study about the how to write the numbers in international system. Thank you children. Hi children, let us continue the class today. So in the previous class you have studied how to write the, put the commas and write the numbers in words in Indian system. Let us continue today how to write the numbers in international system. We have studied in Indian system that how many periods are there? 100 period, 1000 period, then after slab period, crore period, like that it continues. But here what happens? In the international system, the place value is like this. That is, ones, tens, 100, then 1000, 10,000, then 100,000, then million, then 10 million, then 100 million, like it goes on continuous. Okay? So this you have to write it in the form of the words. Okay? So how to write this? Before that, I have to put the commas now. So here, ones, tens, 100 is one group, okay, one period. Then 1000, 10,000, 100,000 is one group. Then million and 10 million is another group. So this you have to write it in the form of words. That is, 78,000,000,921,000,92. Okay, I think you have understood this. So yeah, first we have to write, put the commas, taking 1, 10, 100, one period, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, next million, 10 million. So we have written that in the form of the words, 78,921,092. Okay, let us take another example, that is another sum here. So here, this is ones, tens, 100, next this is 1000, 10,000, then next 100,000, next million. So put the commas. 382 is another one period, then 254 is another period, that is 100,000 period, next comes million. So we should write it in the words here. So here, 7,452,282,283. Okay, I think you have understood this, how to write it in the form of the international system. Okay, so you remember that the place values are 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million, like that it continues. I think you have understood the difference between Indian system and international system. So Indian system starts with 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, like that. But in international system, what happens? Here, three numbers you have to group here. That is 1, 10, 100, then 1000, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million, like that it will continue. And how to write that in the form of the words. Okay. Now let us take next way, that is place commas correctly and write the numerals. If you have given in words, you have to write it in the form of numbers. Okay, so first one, 73,75,307. This is the system of numeration, Indian system, because lakh, thousand and all is there. So let's say you have to write this in the form of the numbers. So I will write that 73 lakh, then 75,000. 307. So this is the answer. So this you have to write, you have given in words, you have to write it in the numbers. Next example, next one, 58 million. So million is what? Which system it is? International system. So 58,423,202. So here you have to group three numbers I told. So here first 58 million. So 58,423,202. Now, okay. So these are the two types. Next, I have explained in the previous class how to compare the numbers. That is, how to compare between the two form of the number. That is, a lakh, 10,000, million, 100,000. That fill in the blanks is given. You have to fill what, how to compare the numbers. So first one, fill in the blanks. Here, 1 lakh equals dash 10,000. So 1 lakh. 1 lakh. What do you write, children? You write like this. Okay. So your 1 lakh. Equals, that is 10,000. 10,000, I will write 10,000. I told you have to compare this one. So here, how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many zeros is left here? Means 1 zero. Means you have to multiply by 10. So here, from this, we will come to know that 1 lakh is equal to 10,000. Okay. So I think